sister here in the Bay, who welcomed me and held me and gave me parts of their soul through me.
It took me about 17 topics to really get to it. And then finally I was like, oh, African dance, like why ain't I writing about this? And the impact that it's had on me spiritually, professionally, self-identity-wise. And I went to the first class. Tamika was the first person I talked to. I don't know if you remember that. You were the first person I talked to. And as we all know, like I never left. I never, ever, ever left.
My first introduction to African dance was in junior high. And we went to an assembly, you know, some regular assembly, but I think it was because we were about to graduate, so they were like, here's Berkeley High, and we're going to show you some of the stuff we're going to do in high school. And I was mesmerized as soon as the dancers hit the stage.
Oh,
it was the African dancers from Berkeley High, who were taught by Anissa Rasheed from Dimensions Dance Theater. And, and everybody was talking and Jocelyn, and I was just like, and so that was my introduction. I got into high school and learned modern Haitian.
There's always a level of learning, you know, like that's why I call myself a master student of the African diaspora, because it's like every time I come to class, I kid you not, I feel like I'm always learning something. I'll be like, you know, or learning how not to kill myself in a different way.
Go join the company and go to
Hustles?
That was 73rd to rehearsal.
Wow.
And I get in there. And my all-time, the person that I just look to for technique is sitting right here.
That's oh
right.
My God.
That's real talk.
I was like, how do I move like that? To me, it's just, it's an extension of who I am.
Listening to Aaron, they talk about blood memory. I think there are some things that are in our blood that get passed down to our blood that I don't care how many people get PhDs in dance, and I don't care how many classes they go to or who they marry.
That's right.
There's something.
Ooh, okay.
Because there's something internally that comes. I do believe in blood memory. I do believe that you carry things in your DNA that connect you to other people and other things.
When Sean just started off by saying her friends are her friends here, you know, Sean's from a whole other spot, you know. Whole other, you know, place, and then just to come to a whole different, you know, yeah. And then these are her, this is her family, you know. So if we get lost and if we wonder like what we should be doing, yeah, it's about the dance is the community. We are the community.
All of us have cited an example when we entered into a rehearsal, you had to have your act right on. We will go through set 6 or 7 different choreographies. If you didn't get in, you didn't fit in. And so that was a place of decorum. You know, you have with some of your teachers where they will mock you to show you what you're doing wrong. And I was still adjusting to dancing that fast and releasing. I was kind of scared someone was going to get hurt. And he had to show me breath to release so that I could fly.
Well, dancing with Blanche Brown and, again, just finding the femininity in the movement was was essential.
You don't dance samba. Samba is very sexy. If you have been shy to be sexy, you cannot dance samba.
I think in coming from a culture and a generation where, you know, the women, the mamas and your aunties are always like, you know, don't shake your booty and walk with your, you know, don't switch and you know, don't do all of that and all of this. And so you basically like tight, you know, and you're scared that people aren't looking at you, got big butt and legs and you like all these men are. It was nice to come into something and come into a dance where it wasn't that sexuality or just sensuous, you know, dance was like, oh, you know, yeah, now let's do a dance that's sexy. No, it was just that this is our body. These chakras are a part of us. This is how we procreate. This is what makes us women. You know, this is what attracts people. You know, this is where our power is. So it was nice to be able to come into that and feel it and dance it in a way where it's not like the hip hop videos, you know, where I'm not saying, look at me, I got this, and ooh, I'm sexy. It was just me being me, you know, and me being a woman.
Some of my favorite dancers, you can tell that they're dancing with people that we can't necessarily see. And whatever it is that they emit, you can kind of feel it surround you, so it kind of fills up the room. And you know, they're just dancing from a higher place.
Mediumships for this dance. This is our culture because it belongs to us. We are not guests, you know. And so when some of us have our consciousness invoked, there's a part of us that yield to receive the training and the technique. And then those ancestors, which are our teachers' ancestors, begin to translate to us, which is what is already familiar to us. And so this body of knowledge that we're sharing, this exchange is kind of critical that it's being documented, because it's an issue that is being lost.